Hey y'all, welcome back to the HOE PHA, a millennial dating experiment.
As you guys know, we are powered by SIRENS NYC, baby.
Yes, and we're coming out of Queens Flip Studios. What's goody? So it's your favorite co-ho, Becky J, your friendly neighborhood sex symbol, ew.
Ew, and it's your actual fave, MJ, repping for all the thickianas all over the world.
Thickianas.
I like that.
You change your intro every
okay,
episode.
And it's still in the same realm,
I feel. I'm gonna work on my shit.
But you already know, it's your boy, RB, representing Punchline Punch. Today, we sipping that Henny Rita. You know what I mean?
Because y'all can already see.
Yeah, you already know. I don't even know if I put that much Rita with this Henny. To be honest,
this is actually my first sip.
The first one?
Yeah, it's my first one.
Yeah.
Oh shit. Oh yeah, just how I like it.
So yeah, if you want to try the Henny Rita and some more of my other, you know, wonderful drinks for the summer, because I got a new summer list out. Follow me on Instagram at Punchline Punch. You know what I mean? Straight like that. So, what's good?
Hey, how are you? How are you guys?
How are we?
How are you?
I'm doing well. For those of you guys who don't know, my birthday is tomorrow, May 20th.
Get it.
I'm about to be 27. So, it's been a very interesting time. This past month has been crazy. Why? Why is your face like that?
Because she's surprised by 27.
No, I'm going to be 27. And I don't know. It's been weird. I feel like around my birthday, I always get kind of like super reflective and super kind of sad sometimes.
Super sad.
Not super sad. Just like.
It's like in the back of your head sad.
Yeah. And that just keeps coming up and you just be like. And I'm like, oh shit, no, okay.
You gotta hold that shit back.
It's just a regular day. It's just a regular day. And it's be like, ugh, like, just mad pressure of life. But I've been good, though. I'm excited. We actually went to a brunch. Canna Crave.
Still recovering.
Canna Crave brunch. Hosted by, put on by Deani. And that shit was insane.
Literally insane. Like, I'd never been more smacked in my life. Like, ever. Like, we reached the fucking threshold yesterday. Like, for sure.
They had infused food, non-infused food. They had treats. We was eating festival dumplings, fried pork. Like, bitch, that shit was good as fuck.
And they let us go with two treats, too.
We had goodie bags, yes.
Like, there was a goodie bag. Mind you, we ate them as soon as we left. Like, we just started eating them, and we're just like, all right. We just started coming down a little bit, and now we just brought us right the fuck back up.
Yeah, it was epic, though. I had so much fun, and then we hit Shimmy, Shemansky's. Shout out to my bros, Ed, Proper Etiquette, Izzy, Good Vibes Worldwide. Shout out to them. That was a little vibe. So, yeah, now I'm here with you guys sipping this Henarita. That's how my weekend was gone.
Y'all seen like y'all was lit yesterday, because when y'all called me, all I saw was Staci laid out. Like, oh.
Was that the day before?
No, that was the day
that
before.
That was yesterday.
When was I laid out?
That was yesterday.
You guys were high.
Oh, wait, you weren't with us day before.
I was with Devin at the taco spot.
No, she was laid out in the front.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
She was laid out. That's all I saw.
Shout out to them. They really have really, really had us fucked up. Like, maybe we should know our limits, or maybe we should push the limits. Who knows? Like, God knows. But
no, I think definitely know your limits. For sure. For sure.
Facts.
Yeah.
I don't have any birthday D this year. I don't think I had any last year. I don't think so. I don't.
You need some? I got a few.
Yeah, I'm like, we're free.
Like, what are you, like a pimp? My God, you need some. I got dick on call for you.
Whoa. Chill. Nah. I mean, like, it's been a few of my niggas who's like, yo, what's up with the, you know what I mean?
And they're going to drop the dick off?
I don't know if they're going to. I'm sure they wouldn't have a problem.
I mean, but how do you know, like, what the dick is like? Like, how, have you heard reviews?
Do you have reviews?
Do you know what the pussy is like before? I mean, like, as a dude, I don't know what the pussy is like before
I taste it or
slide in. So everybody taking chances here.
I ain't taking a chance. I'm going to need at least no more two chances. References.
At least two references.
I need two references to find out what the dude is
car facts
like.
I got to
the whole facts.
I definitely do. I got to be like, okay, do they come back? How many times do the customers return to the store?
It depends on how good the product is.
Oh, exactly.
Exactly.
You need the product, customer service. How is the service? Did you, you know?
The survey and shit, like all of that shit.
All that shit. But yeah, I mean, I guess we'll talk. We'll talk after.
If that's how life really worked. But yeah. Speaking of that whole, you know, you feeling like the, you know, you're not really depressed, but it's like it's a little back, it's a little bit back there. One of my mans gonna text me last night like, yo, we dead almost 30, dog. And I'm just like, god damn, I was having a good night, bro.
Dang.
Like, come on, why you had to do that?
Why
like,
you have to
like
bring
you
that
already
up?
Think about that shit all day anyways. And now he's just brought it right back to the forefront.
Okay, but like I think we have to change like being almost 30, like making it a bad thing, changing it into a good
exactly.
thing.
Exactly. Like 30 is good.
It's a blessing to be almost 30 to reach this age. You know what I mean? I know it's a lot of like pressure, like we think we're supposed to be in a certain place, but I don't know. I just feel like I've never felt better. Every year I always feel like, wow, I'm in such a different
place.
Sorry,
I was thinking about something.
I'm in such a different place. I've, like, learned so many things in the past year. Like, I am so much more me than I've ever been all these years. So I'm more excited to keep learning myself, getting the money so I can get, you know, to really live out the life that I feel on the inside. Like, get that facial money. You know what I mean? Like, when I can get regular facials. Like, that's what's going to happen
massages.
In my 30s. You know?
Get that facial money.
I'm looking forward to that. I can't do that right now, but I'm just like, see, when I'm 30, my pockets is going to be right. Vacations is going to be lit. Facials lit. I'm just going to keep saying facials.
Get that facial money.
I feel like if you're going to do facials, at least with the massages, too. Like,
I'll take a facial, too. Stacey's over there doing jerking moves.
Yeah.
For
like,
all of those
they can
listening.
Still see you over there.
No, but for those listening... For those listening on fucking SoundCloud, she's doing jerking motions as I say facials. But I like
into
those
the direction of D and Tyler.
I'll take those too. I'll take those. But yeah, how you been feeling, MJ?
I've been feeling good. You know, I feel like I'm getting the ball rolling on this job shit and like, you know, this hustle shit. You know, it's starting to fucking like, what's the word when you manifest shit and then it starts to happen?
Unfold.
Yeah, it's starting to unfold and shit, but like dating, I feel like I'm a little lost to that.
Ain't no DM slides?
I don't answer those. I just decline them.
See,
because
your king could be the one.
My
out of
king
the
is not the in fucking Algeria, okay? The fuck? Aww. I'm only getting like Middle Eastern niggas hitting me up like, ooh, look so hot, babe. What am I supposed to do with that? Like,
you should be like, thanks, babe.
Or I'm getting these.
Is loaded.
No.
You're gonna
are
be,
they?
Hey, man.
I'm not trying to get peed on. That's all I can imagine for mad breath.
You're going to be rocking a henna and all that shit, and your bank account is going to be lit.
Mm-mm, I can't. And then also I have, like, these artsy, like, photographer niggas trying to do, like, naked shoots. And then I feel like that's a form of trying to talk to you, which is not okay. And then I have niggas who was, like, artsy. They're cute. And then we start texting.
No artsy niggas.
True, I get that. But yeah, we start texting and then they just fucking disappear. I'm like, why? You like, you didn't have to come in my DMs. You didn't have to get my number. You didn't have to do all of this.
Waste of life.
Tell me what to save your number in my phone as and then like just stop texting me. Like, I don't get it. Yeah. They on some weird shit. So I don't know what this summer is looking like because I'm trying to have fun and shit, but like I'm not trying to put myself through no fucking stress. Yes, hood rat shit with my hood rat fucking friends.
You know what I was thinking, though? It's kind of like what RB was just saying. Like, you know, you still have to be, like, open to, like, the communication, even if the guy's not
oh, that's
for
last
you.
Time.
Or even you, though you yeah, just you said, like, that. The guy might be in your DM, you got to answer the DM.
Yeah,
you know what
fact.
I mean? Just, like,
you know what I mean?
Show the... Okay, listen, not... if he shows you he's not for you, yeah. But I just feel like... being open to communicating with guys and being open to like, hey, instead of just being so closed off, because you never know, the universe is not going to send it to
you. I get that.
You know what I mean?
Because for me, like, last week, I started letting niggas bag me, like, you know, like, it's not the right ones. But I was like, let me, like.
She said, let's open the fucking line of communication.
Let's not judge a book by its cover. Exactly. Let's see, you know what I mean?
Let me just be, show
like,
the universe.
You look like you ain't shit, but.
Let's see.
You know, let me not block the blessing. And once I find out you're shit, okay, cool. I need to show the universe I'm open. See what you, okay, this is what you give me. Now you can go. So I just, that's the process. I let this fucking, my car broke down last week. This on my way to work, and the tow truck guy gonna pull up. Then you know I'm waiting for my Uber because he couldn't drive me to work. I'm like, my God, you couldn't drive me to work, but whatever.
And he bagged you. Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, we think that bags. I mean, it was also a whole big ass tow truck. So yeah, so we're talking, and I'm just like sitting there. I'm like, can I bum a cigarette off you? I'm smoking a cigarette in his car, and he like bagged me. Like, yeah, I need a girl, this and that. Can I get your number? I'm like, what you do? Like, I gave him a look.
What you mean this?
I do this.
Yeah, he's at work 7 days a week. I'm like.
First of all, red flag. 7 days a week. That nigga has no time for you.
No, and but he's saying he works 5 days a week, but he just goes in the other days because he doesn't have anything to do. Which
that's
is kinda
a red flag.
Is it a red flag? Whatever.
Not having nothing to do.
That means on days that means you don't work. Ain't nobody in his DMs. Ain't nobody in his
DMs. Exactly.
In his
inbox. I like my person to be sweated a little bit. You know, be busy. Do
guys,
shit.
Clearly I said this wasn't my guy. I was just going through the motions.
Yeah, we give him advice. Like, hey,
I was going through the motions to show the universe, hey, I'm open, you know? Like, I'm here for the conversation. But yeah, then he's texted me the next day saying, oh, why don't you come get me from work? First of all, I was like, don't you drive for work? You can get me. But anyways, I was like, why don't you come get me? I want to just cuddle up with you. I was like, are you serious? I was like, really?
Red flag number two.
And I was just like, yeah, all I need is two flags. I was like, really? Like, this is a little forward. We just met. And he was like, he was like, don't take it the wrong way. It was just more of an idea than a request.
Oh.
Still.
An idea you should have kept to your motherfucking self, yeah. Sir.
Okay, so now I've deducted this conclusion. This nigga's lonely.
Duh.
Clearly.
This nigga's mad.
We've been said this.
He go in on the extra days that he doesn't have to go because he has nothing to do.
Exactly.
This nigga's lonely. He got work to make friends.
I asked the nigga, I was like, do you have like any ambitions? Like what you do? Like what's your dreams? What's your goals? He's like, you can find out on our date. Clearly you don't, because them other 2 days could have been that's what you dream. It was a no, guys. I know. And then after he sent me that text, I blocked him. And then boom. But I'm just showing the universe, like, send them. Start sending them. I'm going to go through them. I'm going to let you know if they're for me. But the floodgates. Open the floodgates. Send them my way. Let me see.
Okay.
I start juggling these niggas. Like, that's what I'm trying to do.
Be careful driving, because I don't want you to this shit to break down. That nigga pull up like, oh. You need help again?
Oh, you need help? Nah, bitch. And then pull off of my ass.
Ask that next nigga.
Facts.
That's not okay.
Do you have a hot tip?
A hoe tap. I do not, actually. I've decided I don't like those. Okay, y'all. So, welcome to Holistic, where your favorite coho MJ tells you how to get your hoe face popping as fuck.
Yeah. It's Holistic. Hey, it's Holistic.
Suck that dick.
It's okay. Holistic. Hey, it's Holistic.
She gonna pop that.
Hey, Holistic. Hey, it's Holistic.
Put the finger in the butt.
Holistic. Hey, Holistic.
Take no chances.
I didn't like that part. Take no chances.
Take no chances on what, my guy? On what?
I don't know. It just came out. I was trying to.
It's okay. Last week I was doing it and I was like, yeah, he gonna eat that ass. So Becky thought I said, we gonna eat that ass? And she was just like, oh, listen.
I've done that.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay.
Don't.
Let's table that.
I've done that. Don't be fooled. There's niggas out here getting their asses ate.
We, trust me,
it.
We know.
Guys, I just started watching like rimming porn, so it's hot.
Whoa, I forgot it was Holistic.
Sorry, you're right.
So sorry, guys.
My fault.
But yeah, so you know, I tell y'all how to get y'all whole face popping as fuck. But I feel like I have missed the main fucking thing. And y'all are going to think I'm talking about something else, but I'm not. I'm talking about safety. And not just when it comes to sex. I'm talking about putting yourself in dangerous situations with people you don't fucking know. Okay? I've been there. Staci, you're shaking your head. Yes, I know. All of you. Probably all of you. But yeah, so the main thing I would say to do, because I know y'all little hoe asses. Y'all like danger. Y'all like that shit. I know y'all do.
Dick but, in danger.
Yep.
The double D.
The double D.
I'm the whole thing.
It makes my belly throb just a little. Slightly.
Like, I'm saying that?
I'm mortified.
Okay.
Okay. So rule number one, you need to make sure that at least two of your friends have your location. Not just one, because one of them is the one whose phone is always dead. Just so I'm saying, make sure to have your location. Or, yeah.
Is that Shay?
Occupied. It is Shay. Niggas need you, okay? Niggas be needing you.
Okay, bitch. Then.
Me and Staci like to go to Jersey, okay? We need you.
Okay, fair enough.
So that's number fucking one. Number two. I forgot what else fuck I was going to say. Oh, yeah. Number two, please screen these niggas, okay? Before, like, I need you to go through Instagram, Facebook. I know it sounds like stalking, but no. It's making sure that you're fucking safe. Because you could be on Instagram and he's flexing all his money and shit. Then you go on Facebook and last week was Lil Shanae's birthday. She's turning 3 and he's in the picture with her with the fucking mother, okay? Screen these niggas.
Whole facts,
okay?
Two references.
Reviews. 3, make a friend screen him too. Or find out some hoe facts. See if somebody knows him. Because I'm tired of fucking trying to talk to niggas and then finding out that the baby mama is pregnant and all this other shit. Like, that shit is not fun. So, I
mean, we really not together.
Exactly.
Right now,
like, and if people,
about.
Yeah, people can see shit that you don't fucking see. So that's, I know people be scared to bring their niggas around. It's because they're going to see it. It's because we're going to see it. So make sure these niggas is screened. Share your location. That's all I'm fucking saying, okay? It's rough out here in these streets, okay? Men are crazy. Women are crazy. Trans are crazy. Gay is crazy.
All of y'all.
Just, everybody, yeah. Everybody losing their fucking minds out here.
Out here. So. Like, relax, okay? Stop putting your whole ass in danger. That's all I got to say.
I like that one. Safety. And that's something that we practice in our craft. I think I got to send it to one more person.
Your location?
Yeah, me too. No, I got to.
What's happening?
You and Staci.
It's in their exact location.
What's exactly. Mm. Oh.
What's
you can share your exact location.
Indefinitely?
Mm-hmm. Right then and there.
Mm. Like, what's that? All right.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Right. Check that out, y'all. Les like, trust me, I stalk. I know. Okay, I like that, MJ.
I'm just trying to help y'all have a better whole summer, okay? Trying to be happier this summer, not sad.
Yeah, you know that's a fact. Like, I've heard
what?
I've heard stories of, I mean, granted, I'm a firm believer in you get what you allow. And if you did that shit, then low-key you really wanted to do it. But, like, sometimes I'll be feeling like hearing a few of these stories, it's like, yo, niggas be fiending, son.
Absolutely.
And sometimes girls just do shit to, like, get in and out of that situation.
Yeah, get out alive.
That's not okay either.
Yeah, it's not okay, but at the same time, it's just like, yeah, I mean, something real serious can happen if you like
exactly
don't like play along, and that's the type of like stigma that we got to get out of, you know.
Yeah.
What I mean,
I think,
like, I feel like safety is a real big thing, especially because the summer is coming around, like everybody just with the vibe, everybody just, you know, oh, we drinking, we smoking, like we going with them,
less
we mobbing
clothes
with them, like, bitch, it's, I don't even know them, like, what are you doing, like,
yeah,
you know what I mean, so.
Dudes too, but also women.
Happen. I'm sorry, that would never happen.
No, never say never.
Like, text themselves, like, no, they're like,
I don't mean that in totality. Of course, there are, like, you know, respectable men out there. But I mean, like, as far as, like, the niggas who just going, you know what I mean? Yo, hey, yo, ma, you beautiful. I love you, ma. They going to always be there. So it's just like.
Well, not that. I'm not talking about that aspect. I'm talking about the aspect of when it gets up on you. You're like, you just chilling with them. It gets up on you. You're just like, I don't want to do this. And they like, oh, well. You know, it's like.
Oh, when they're like, oh, but you're here.
Yeah, exactly. You're here. Like, I already bought you weed and all that shit. It's like, but so what? I still don't want to do something.
It doesn't equal, just because I'm hanging out with you, doesn't equal we're having sex. So like that. Yeah. And I think also what you got, it goes back to what MJ was saying. Like, there are flags and stuff. And if not, those men are creep. You know, the creepy men are going to be creeps anyways. They're going to pretend and then they're going to, if you're going to rape a bitch, you're going to just rape a bitch. You're just, you got something fucked up in your head. But I think there are ways, you know, you can screen and just, you know, don't be going to the niggas' houses. You don't know them. Like, little things like that to help you be at least a little more.
Yeah, and then if you're going to be going to this nigga's house to smoke and not fuck, bring your friend. Yeah. Let her get high, too.
Yo, I will never, I will always remember the time that I got just slightly pissed off because I thought this chick was coming over. You know, we was going vibe. We was going, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. All of that. She bring her friend. I'm just like...
And then it's like, that could be a vibe too, though. Sorry. Sorry, that's what I thought.
It was kind of a blessing in disguise because the friend ended up being my shorty for 2 years.
Oh, wow. RB. You messy, RB.
You are. You really are.
That brings me back.
We'll talk about it later.
It will.
We'll have a therapy discussion with you.
Oh, please.
Yes. All right, but that brings me to my TMI. It doesn't, but then y'all was going to keep talking, so now it brings me to my TMI.
Yeah.
Welcome to TMI, where I give you too much information about a certain topic.
Are you ready? It's TMI. Hey, it's TMI. We're going to spit some facts. Yeah.
Too much information.
You know what? This is what happens when you try... I'm not giving up. Okay.
No, you're going to give up the facts. You're going to
give up the facts. The whole facts.
Show us the facts.
Okay, I'm just going to need you guys to rehearse during the break. Okay. I'll go down on the song. It's getting there. It's getting better. It's getting better the weeks.
It was better than last week.
Way better. Way better. So I like it. All right, guys. Today, welcome. Welcome to TMI. Today, we're going to be talking about perspective. Okay. Ooh. Another one of those buzzwords that are getting thrown around all over the motherfucking place. But what the fuck does it mean?
And how do you spell it?
Perspective.
Because a lot of y'all motherfuckers need spell check.
Out here talking about perspective and shit.
Fact. Perspective. Okay, perspective. This is the definition. It's a particular attitude towards something, a way of regarding something, or simply a point of view. So now, why are we talking about perspective? Sometimes when you're in a situation, you need to shift your perspective. Boop. You know, you know sometimes you're in the vibe. You're in your feelings. Something's going on. You're like, oh my God, this is the end of the world. Because that's your perspective. Boop. Get a little higher. Bird's eye view. No, change your point of view. Sometimes you look at the situation, I'm mad. I just got fired. I'm so sad. But if you just get a little different perspective, you're like, oh, shit.
I was always late.
Facts. You can get a perspective of your boss. Like, how would I think about this if I was the boss in the situation and this was my employee? Okay, that makes sense. If you get an even bigger bird's eye view, you're just like, oh, shit. Now this gives me more time to focus on my art. And maybe this is exactly what I needed to do. You know what I mean? So sometimes you need to shift your perspective. Sometimes, I know for me, sometimes I'd be too much in the clouds. And I'd just be like, everything is nothing. And everything is going exactly the way it needs to be. And my ass has sat down for 2 weeks and only smoked blunts and didn't do anything. Because I need to change my perspective and get in the bitch. Get in the world, bitch.
Get in.
Send some motherfucking emails. Go outside and do shit. You know what I mean? Perspective. Change your perspective. If you're in the situation and you need to get a different view on what's going on, remember, it's your perspective, baby. Okay. You guys have been great. Thank you. I
And that was TMI.
All right, let's get into this question of the week, because it's been a lot of craziness going on in the news lately about, you know, women's rights and reproductive rights. So we decided this episode, we're going to put it on blast.
Yeah, we getting real serious with this one.
Bitch. You say that as you die, as you start dying laughing.
It's the Henny Rita.
It really is. It really is. So it's you.
You read the question.
Oh, this shit.
This is your cue.
Shit. Okay, y'all. So, yeah, like I said, we're getting serious this week. So this week we asked our listeners, what are your views on abortion?
Yes. And I'm happy. I'm also excited that we have RB here to get some testosterone and some male perspective on this topic, too.
Yeah, see what you think. I think
you guys should start with RB.
We'll see. You know what? Before we answer the question and before we introduce our awesome guests who have already been giving amazing commentary, we're going to have a quick word from our sponsors. So we'll be right back, bitch.
Bye.
Hey, y'all, we are back. Thank you guys so much for listening. And now we have an amazing episode today, okay? Because my birthday's tomorrow, I wanted to bring it in with my motherfucking sisters. So we got the Sirens in the building.
Yeah, where's the siren sound?
So we got the real Staci B.
Yeah, what's up, y'all?
We have D Bomb
here.
And Tyler.
Hey.
That's Love Me Ty.
Over there.
All right, so thank you guys so much for coming. Love you guys so much.
Thanks for having us. And I love you more.
I don't know. I'm sure you guys on YouTube or on Instagram Live, y'all hear all the commotion and stuff going on, because we're really a family, and this is just y'all just capturing us in the moment. Okay? Oh, my God. So y'all heard the question of the week, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Should we recap it? Let's recap it.
Recap it. Okay.
We could if you like.
Basically, all these niggas, not niggas.
Oh, that is not how Marissa, the question
Marissa,
starts.
Marissa, please.
No, listen. Police? Basically, all these states and their governments or whatever decided to vote and put restrictions on their fucking abortion laws. So we decided, So we decided to make this episode about abortion. So we asked our listeners, what are your views on abortion? So we can get more deeper into what the fuck it is we're actually talking about.
Yes, and to be clear, there aren't any laws, but they're pushing bills.
Pushing bills. Okay, pushing some bills have passed.
No, they have not passed.
The one in Alabama passed? Yeah, and Georgia.
Yeah, the Alabama, Georgia, Missouri.
There's like eight states. Yeah.
You can't even leave the state with the baby because you get like charged for like conspiracy. So weird.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, shit. So, bitch ain't reading.
Like, shit is real. Yeah. And somebody can't even take you out of the country either because they'll get in trouble with you.
Yeah. It's just a whole bunch of shit.
A whole bunch of shit.
But you can go state to state, though.
No.
I would tell my cousin, send me a pill.
But if you want an abortion, you shouldn't even get that far that they know that you're pregnant. If I want, I know if I want an abortion, so why am I telling people, hey, I'm having a baby, and then have an abortion? Makes no sense.
That's fair.
I'm having a baby.
Okay,
but some people actually do that. Some people actually be like, yo, I think I'm pregnant. Oh my God, I'm pregnant. Oh my God, I think I'm pregnant. Oh my God, hush up.
But you know what your loophole is?
Right, but you don't say
your loophole is not doing it through insurance and just doing it straight cash.
Straight cash.
Because when
that doesn't sound
like none of it.
But when you do it through your insurance, that's a paper trail. And then they're gonna have the means to be like, oh, you went out of state.
Wait, where are you getting cash abortions at? Like,
right.
But now we
under
don't
the
find
table.
Out where.
Well, I think okay, wait.
Let's checking cash, please.
Let's everybody go around and say what their personal views are on abortion, okay. And we'll start from there and see how everything goes. Who wants to start?
I'll start.
Okay, Ty.
I think abortion is important. It's important because that means the mother, the person who's having this child, doesn't want the child. or whatever reason there is, but pretty much you don't want the child. It doesn't, you don't need it right now. It's going to take up time, space, and you're not in a mood right now.
I don't need that right now.
I don't need it. So for you to tell me that you're forcing me to keep something that I don't want, it's crazy.
So you believe that everyone, everybody should have the choice.
Yeah, because if I don't want something, I don't want it. And I'd be damned if this baby kill me. And I'm dead on the abortion bed. I'd be damned. Like, hell no. No, not an abortion bed. Having a baby.
Having a baby, right?
on the hospital bed. Like, the delivery bed, mad as hell. Like, what? I don't even want it and you killing me? Get out.
Right. What about you, D?
I'm definitely pro-choice. I feel like abortion, it needs to be a thing. It needs to be
a choice.
Yeah, we need to have that choice. People just get put in situations and, you know, like, imagine a mother having a kid that she didn't even want. You know how much hate she's going to have for that baby? It's just so much that goes into it, and yeah, no. I'm so pro-choice. I can't even think about not having a choice because I would just be miserable if I had no choice. Like, so, yeah.
Period. Staci?
Yeah, I'm definitely pro-choice. I just believe that women, the people, you know, who are actually carrying this child for 9-10 months, to be exact, actually, maybe a little more, you know, 11. Mm-hmm. I was in there for about 12, you know what I'm saying? But even still.
Kyle XY.
I came out late. Long story.
long story.
But in all reality, like, you know, we should have all choices on what should go on with our body, whether we want to keep a baby or not. And in regards to, like, you living, like, I'm about to, you know, do some in the next 5 years. I'm not thinking about a baby, but God forbid, you know, you having a fun night, you know, some little slip up, you know what I'm saying? You said pull out game was strong, and it wasn't. You know what I'm saying? Then, you know, you could, it's up to you. It's your full-on choice of what goes on with your body. Like, I don't think no man should have any say on abortion rights. Any say on abortion rights. Like,
exactly.
Yeah. Because the Period. Same way a nigga could get a girl pregnant. Oh, excuse me. The same way a guy could get a girl pregnant.
No, we like nigga here.
Too. The same way a nigga can get a bitch pregnant.
Not anybody a nigga.
You feel me? Is the exact same way a nigga could leave the bitch when she's pregnant.
Yeah.
So, if they could leave, we should all have the right to
Right, know. And we're going to be stuck with the baby.
Right, by ourselves. That
Make
shit is
that
not
illegal.
Fair. Not fair at all.
You can't leave the baby.
But yeah, that's my...
Right. I mean, technically, right? It is illegal. Not that you can't leave the baby, but you still have to be able to provide for your
right.
child. You know
but
what I mean?
That's so. The mother... wants that to happen.
Yeah.
Now you make it mandatory. No, who cares if the mother wants it to happen? Shoot, they change their name. They're like, who the daddy?
Who the daddy?
You can't find me.
You just killed me.
You can leave all the babies you want. Fuck it.
You can't find that nigga. What? What's the point?
You got my last name. Because
they be different. Like, you need to provide paperwork. You have to, like, serve them with something.
Yeah. Something.
They have to do a test to say this is prove that this is the child's body.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Yeah, they could dip.
They about to call Maury.
Oh, D.
It's ooh, crazy. Right.
Maury's back for another season.
Woo.
Chasing
niggas down.
The camera chasing niggas down.
Right.
For 20
oh, my
years.
God. The camera.
Chasing them down.
Bitch rolling all over the step.
I'd be sad when they're not the father, though.
Because
then who's the dad?
No,
but then they'd be like, do you know who the dad is?
Yo, I hate
is?
When
they'd be like,
three
yeah.
people
and I'm like,
there and none of them the dad. Like, at least.
It's like, sis, you've been here for 12
nigga
episodes. This is nigga number
nigga
13.
Be like, I promise.
She said, yo.
Whatever happens, I got you.
Yep, and then he's not the dad.
Nigga be
then
crying.
He be hype. Hype, wait. Like, bye.
Yeah.
All right. MJ, what is your view on abortion?
Okay. And this might upset a few people, but I appreciate everything you guys said. I am also pro-choice. However, like, I believe, like, if I get pregnant right now, I'm having an abortion. That's why I'm on birth control. But whatever. I just want to say, I'm pro-abortion. I get it. Even if you have 3 kids and you're not ready for that 4th kid, go ahead and abort that fucking baby. Like, do all the shit. Like, it doesn't matter what your reasoning is. go ahead. If that's not what your plan is, do that. I just want to say, for safety reasons, like, abortion is not birth control. Like, there's a difference, like, because there's about so many abortions you can really have before it's three. You can have three.
Marilyn Monroe had like nine of them. She had like 23.
But did she have children after that? No, yeah, you can't.
She didn't have kids because she didn't want them, but she had like mad
abortions. They probably had different abortions back then.
Really, the wire hanger.
Yeah, you're more at risk to have children.
Yeah, but they said you could still have them, but you just. Oh.
Yeah.
Damn.
Look at how it's making me clench my legs.
You went to what you said? Your risk is dying by getting like multiple abortions.
But it's the hurt pulse.
So yeah, like I'm saying, abortion is not birth control. So like you need to either practice safer sex or get on some type of what's this shit called?
Birth control.
But no, what's the word called? Contraceptive. Like something like that, because you can't just be out here recklessly with your body and you keep getting pregnant and like,
and then popping a plan B of Skittles.
Yeah, like, you know, like it's right. Not really safe for you.
How many plan Bs can you have?
Exactly.
Plan B doesn't work if you're pregnant already, though.
Yeah. No, I think you can have, I think you can do a few plan Bs.
They say after 2 days you can't take it.
Yeah, but
I gotta read the Bible.
If you're already pregnant, it's not gonna work.
3 days, my bad.
Oh, no, I know that.
Why are we in more than 3 days?
In a day?
All
right,
it'll pass.
Imagine a fourth day you take a plan B.
My mom told me if you're going to have unprotected sex, you're not supposed to have sex 7 days before and 7 days after because you're still out bleeding. So let's say, for example, within those 7 days you have sex. You're not bleeding. You're not doing any of that. But you have sex and you get pregnant and the sperm goes to your egg. Plan B doesn't do shit. It's not like it's not.
Are you sure?
Listen, don't
bet nothing
me.
Yeah.
That's it. If you look it up, it'll tell you. You can't do that.
Yeah. This ain't no free ball.
I think the whole, the point is more so to just practice safe sex and not use abortion
as an out.
As an out.
Yeah, as a contraceptive.
Yeah. What about you, RB? Let's get some male perspective in the building.
Ooh, perspective. Ooh. I'm drunk, first of all.
Thank you for the what is the word? The disclaimer.
Okay, so look, peep. All right. I'm pro-choice and I'm a firm believer in everybody should be allowed to do what they body, whatever they please.
Period.
You know,
thank you.
You know,
do you feel like guys have an
go ahead I'm
do
okay.
You feel like guys should have an input on whether or not, like, if their girlfriend wants to get an abortion?
That's a whole separate question.
I feel head. Like if you should only have an input as a man if you are dealing with said woman.
Okay,
what
if and only if you are in a relationship with that woman, or you know, involved with that woman, and that child is going to be your child as well, then I feel like as a man you should have some say in whether or not, like, this baby is
shit. Born.
It depends. It depends.
It's true.
It definitely depends. And
wait, you said if you're dealing with the woman, what do you mean by that? If you're involved, aren't you dealing with her?
If you're involved with the, you know, the woman that you're dealing with who is perceived to be pregnant, then I feel like you should have some say. You know what I mean?
I was talking to MD about this in the car.
Literally.
And I was like, some say, but like,
how much say?
You're never going to have more say than the woman. So what does your say matter? Yeah. You know what I mean? It's just like, what, you want 40% say?
I think so.
Mm-hmm. I would like some consideration, especially if this shit was a mistake. Especially if I'm not one of these niggas like, oh, I'm going to get you pregnant type shit. Like, if we both know this was a mistake, then we both should really sit down and go over the pros and cons of having a child in this world right now while me and you are in our states right now.
I'ma just say, if a nigga tries to force me to have a baby, he's gonna be a single dad.
Or an abortion.
You not gonna.
Oh, or an
Or an abortion.
They should have say, but I'm saying, if I'm especially, pregnant.
Especially if we're gonna be with you.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Okay.
There's some one night stands who don't, like some guys who don't believe in abortions who will actually stick around. Like some, not everybody, but some guys who would stick around, like even if they don't believe in like that.
Cause I wouldn't even want that.
That sounds like the least.
I think it's more of like a personal choice.
I don't know. Like,
but
I feel like it's more of a personal choice if you hit that nigga up, like. Hey, so you remember that other night, you know, where we, and he's just like,
some people don't even tell the people
I'm pregnant.
Yeah.
Do you guys?
What you plan on doing?
Do you guys think that the woman, if she's pregnant, she should tell the man that she's dealing with?
If she's involved with them, maybe.
Heavily. If she's like heavily involved with them.
Can I say something?
I think, right, that I can't even speak right now.
You think?
Okay. So, I just believe that if the girl feels, like, say the girl missed her period, right? She's like, all right, fuck, damn, I think I'm pregnant. She could, depending on what the guy is doing, and he could be talking to every bitch in America, like, I swear to God, bro, every bitch on campus. All right, every bitch on campus. We're talking about every bitch on campus.
Whoa.
Right? And you can literally, I feel, you could keep that to yourself and do what you got to do, mm-hmm. especially if it's for yourself and your own sanity and your own, you know, physical health. You feel me? Like,
I feel like,
but it's that's inevitable.
You know that nigga's
yeah.
not with
you. Yeah. And you already, if, yeah, wait, I was about to say, you already know. You already know for a fact that he is dealing with XYZ, like other bitches, and you know, like. You know you're not the only one, so it's like, damn, I'm not gonna be this dumb bitch. You feel me? Like,
what if how does that make you a dumb kids? Bitch though? To get pregnant? It's just biology.
Yeah, it's just biology, but at the same time.
No, to get pregnant and depend on and somebody who's not even really paying that much attention to you.
Yeah, in the relationship, 100%.
Okay.
But what if he's in the relationship?
And to try to include them. Meanwhile, they fucking all the bitches on campus.
But I don't think that takes away someone's biological rights. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I think it's because they're not a good father, it means because they're not a good boyfriend doesn't mean they can be a good father.
I mean, because of the fact that the stress and everything and having to like chase them down and stuff like that, that's also a bad thing too, because like that could go either way. I guess it's situational depending on how well you know that person. Because they could be a hoe and still a good person to talk to, but they could be a hoe and also somebody you know that's not mature. Someone who's not financially stable,
you know, is not ready.
Who doesn't have, like, you know. No, I'm saying, like, there's different types of hoes as far as the guys, you know. Mm-hmm. Like, they don't have shit going for them, you know.
I think you gotta consider how you feel about
the situation. Was you really trying to fuck with that nigga long term?
I think my question is more so like, even if you don't want anything to do with the person, does that mean they don't have a right to know that they conceived a child?
Yeah.
Like, my
that's
goodness.
How you feel.
Yeah. Because if I don't feel like I'm the woman, if not 100% ready, health-wise, mental-wise, physical-wise, I'm not having a child. I'm letting you know because I have a whole different 9 months. So if I'm fucked up, my baby's fucked up too because it's inside of me. Yeah. So I'm not dealing with the stressing of you and 100 other bitches and 100 other women and telling you and you in my face saying, why you do this? Mm-hmm. I don't care.
That's more stress.
I don't want to hear it. I don't want to listen to it. Leave me alone.
Yeah.
Mind your business.
I've been through that. You have to tell the dude because it's a process to go through it.
Yeah, I was going
to
say that.
Even if you don't care, just to have him there, because if something happens, he's at fault too.
Wait, what do you mean?
He's at fault too. It takes two to make a baby.
That's what so I was going to say. That's why I think
but
it's situational.
I'm saying if anything can happen. If something happened to you in the operating room or whatever, and he doesn't know, like, oh, it's technically partly his fault. Mm.
Dang.
I think it's situational.
Wait, but I'm saying he's saying, what if you die?
Blame it on me. It's my fault.
I
kept it a secret.
I didn't tell you.
What were you gonna say, D?
It's my fault.
Yeah. What were you gonna say, D?
I was just gonna say, depending on the situation, like sometimes you just have to tell somebody. You don't want to go through that by yourself, whether or not he's gonna be there. I don't know.
You have family though. You can tell your family.
Wait, let me finish. I don't know.
Family, friends.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I think me personally, because I didn't really tell my view of abortion, but I'm pro-choice. I believe in abortion. I've actually have had an abortion, and going through that process, I totally agree with Space. I would absolutely tell the man because it's something that they're gonna go through as well. It's not just something that's so like. Oh, willy-nilly, and it's not just you going through the situation. Having a child, it literally takes two. I know a lot of women, because we are,
carrying
the child, you feel so much more attached to it, but I think there is a lot of processing that goes through with men as well, and I think just letting them in on that, that's me personally what I would do. And yeah, so I believe in abortion, I believe in, you know, choices, but I think a lot of the times, people make it seem like it's just such an easy thing. Like, oh, yeah, I'm pregnant. Oh, yeah, I'm just going to have abortion. Yeah, I don't care. Let me go to the club. You know what I mean? It's not. It's a very traumatic experience. And it takes a certain mindset for a woman to say, hey, I'm going to kill my child. You know what I mean? Like, it's not like an easy thing. It's not like the way that a lot of the conversations go along. It's just like, oh, yeah, you just have an abortion. So it takes a certain mindset for you to really be aware of your situation and to say, like, hey, I'm going to actually make this decision. And it's something that affects you for the rest of your life, something that affects you for months afterwards. Physically, you're, like, literally bleeding and bleeding out for months. I mean, for, like, weeks and weeks after that. So it's not really this, like, easy thing. And I think people need to understand that. It's a psychological thing as well. So it someone is making that choice, understand it's for a very good reason. Or it's not something that's taken lightly.
Okay. So, yeah. to further wrap up my perspective. Mm-hmm. I drink. Was that one of the words?
Yes, yeah, drink every time you hear perspective, y'all.
Yes, I am pro-choice. However, and this goes back to what you said about not using it as
birth control.
As birth control or any type of contraceptive. I have been a victim and a product of what's the word I'm looking for? Of scare tactics.
Oh, like lying, saying you're pregnant?
God, I'm pregnant.
No. having a rule set in place so that you just won't do anything that allows you to be in any type of radius to break that rule.
For example.
Yeah. For example, there are a lot of unfit there are a lot of unfit parents. Mm-hmm. A lot of unfit parents. Mm. Okay? And only playing devil's advocate, I would never pass this as an actual law, but looking on the other side of it, it would stop people from having
unprotected sex.
Yeah. With somebody who they possibly don't see a future with, or with the idea of not having a slip up, because they know if a baby comes along, if they get pregnant or whatever, then they're not gonna have a chance to abort it. So it's like, I can kind of see how that, I don't even know if that's the agenda.
It's you know what business.
I
mean?
I doubt it. I doubt that's the agenda, but like, to look at it in a light that's not all that, see that as being one of the agendas. Never, but at the same it time, it's like, nah, you know. But
telling me anybody I have sex with, I have to kind of want a baby with.
Yes, that's what I was gonna
exactly
say.
Exactly.
But what if you just horny? Like, no.
Like a year or something or so ago. Like, why are you? You was like, you mentioned something about this, like, why are you having sex with someone that you don't ever see yourself having a child with, or like,
or unprotected sex with them?
Yeah, that's the thing. Yeah. Unprotected sex, like, there's condoms out there.
Trust me, I know what happens.
Unprotected sex. Why are you having it with anybody in the world?
Yeah.
Okay.
With anybody.
I don't know. I'm not going to talk. I don't know what happens. Uh-huh. But, you know, people be having sex. I'm going to say sex. People don't like condoms. Understandable.
Listen.
But people are allergic to condoms. So.
I think conversation about, like, about having a child and about conceiving a child happens way too late. Yes. Because it needs to happen
on first date
while you guys are having
before you have sex. Like, okay, you have choosing to have sex with someone is you choosing that there's a possibility. Whether it's the 0.1% from the condom, whether y'all just the 50% from the pullout method,
whether it's the condom slipped off, now the stuff is inside of you.
Oh,
whatever
I hate that
it is,
shit.
There
put
are
on the wrong way.
No, but yeah, pre-cum, whatever it is.
The condom never slipped off in you.
Right. It don't matter if it's big. Listen, it don't matter if it's big, because sometimes they get smaller when they get soft.
Yeah, when it's small, the condoms too big.
No, because most of the time when, well, at one point before I was in the whole face, but
but before that, I was having sex with people I was with for 2-3 years, so I wasn't using condoms. They were like my boyfriends. Mm-hmm. So before that, but I mean, my whole phase was kind of like, but I never had it slip off, like.
Multiple times and multiple plan B's. Yes.
But that's besides the point. The whole point is The whole point is I feel like choosing to lay down with someone, even my mom said this to me, choosing to lay down with someone is choosing there's a chance that I'm gonna have a child with this person. So all of the people want to have all these arguments and but don't have standards for themselves before they have sex with people. But now it's like, oh, this and that. Now I'm this and now I'm that. I think that just needs to be a part of the conversation too. People being more conscious and moral, like you were saying. If I don't think making abortion illegal would make people be more conscious of who they have sex with. I think that should be what we're teaching people. You know what I mean? Like, let's just be conscious of what we're doing and of our actions. And yeah, stuff like that.
But what about rape victims?
Yeah, what about the rape and incest? They said it doesn't matter if it's rape or incest, you have to have this baby.
Well, you know what? Here's what I have to say about that, because I feel like
that's too much now.
They did these abortion bills or whatever, and now the president is like, oh, he wants to include, like, you know, some acceptances for, like, if you were raped or if it's incest or whatever. But I'm just like, do they think that a woman is more likely to get pregnant from being raped than from just being reckless? Like, I feel like that's a bigger fucking conversation. Yeah. Because if they're making exceptions for rape or for incest, but I'm saying, do they think that's more likely to happen for someone to just get pregnant and want an abortion rather than just not using fucking condoms?
Just someone who's just
living. Yeah.
Right. Just made the choice to have sex, and I was just like, hey, now, I don't.
And
I feel like
It is likely for people to get raped, but I'm saying the bigger conversation should be about rape it fucking self than about abortion, you know?
But then the annoying part is that people call it fake rape. Like saying, oh, I got raped. So what if people, now they have to say that because people would be like, oh, I got pregnant. Now I'm calling rape because I'm pregnant.
So and this is the only way that I can end that
part. Yeah. But what about the incest part? What?
That incest shit is...
And the incest makes no sense.
No, but I'm saying that is... It's a... I think I see what MJ's talking about, though. They use that to push a different point.
Like, that's the only acceptable reason as to why someone would want an abortion.
Exactly, and that's probably... That's not a reason. I feel like that's an exception to the rule. Incest is an exception to everything. Like, you know what I mean?
Exactly.
Rape isn't... Exactly.
At all.
I do have a question, though. So you know how they're passing all of these bills and stuff for to make abortion illegal. What do you guys think about illegal abortions? Do you think that's going to go on the rise if they start?
Absolutely. Imagine if I'm fucking 13, I'm pregnant. I can't tell my fucking parents. I can't go to the fucking Planned Parenthood because that shit's going to be gone. I'm going to just get me a good old fucking
hanger.
They're going
to Shanae in the basement of the hood. That's what we're going
or
to
like
get my
pushing themselves down the stairs.
Yep. Getting somebody to punch you in the stomach.
Drinking certain things.
Drinking Clorox.
Like, I feel like that's worse for a fucking baby.
But then now they're arresting people for suspicion of pregnancy. Abortion. Exactly. Oh, you put yourself down the stairs? Oh, word? Okay, now you're getting arrested because you're pregnant.
And, like, you could get arrested for that, but you get fucking a fine for raping a fucking 14-year-old. Like, it doesn't make sense. It's not equal.
I mean, if they do, let's say if they do go through with making it illegal and stuff like that, I mean, isn't it kind of dope that they make it that if you get raped and it's incest that you have an option?
But what about the rest of us?
That's dope for who?
For people who've been raped? And people who's in incest, because, I mean, now at least, like, because another thing, too, why I feel like they brought up the rape thing, because that's where it started from. A lot of people were trying, people who were getting raped, the rapist is like, oh, well, I want my kid. I still want my kid. You know what I mean? And then the conversation came up all about abortion and abortion or whatever. So I feel like it is kind of a win if rape and incest is included in, is taken out of it, and that you have an option, because a lot of people do get raped. A lot of women do get raped. It may not happen as much like to people you know and stuff, but it does happen, you know?
But to
and
me,
I, feel like
I don't,
the option is, it's better than nothing. I mean, I would hope they don't make it legal because I'm pro-choice, but I feel like it's better than nothing.
You don't feel like it'll be a lot of women crying wolf out of that situation?
Yeah, that's what Tyler
just said. That's the only scary thing about it. That woman's going to cry wolf.
They do that now.
He raped me. I want an abortion.
But that's the thing.
I've seen that a billion times.
So it's like, I don't.
They're still going to do it. So it's just like, I feel like for there to be an option that you, if you do get raped, then you can prove that you got raped.
It should be like, but you don't know. Like, you can make up a whole story. I can make up a whole story. Anybody can make up a whole story about how they got raped. It's a story.
True.
So
I think it's a small win, but I think the bigger picture of abortion and abortion rights are for women, all women to have autonomy over their bodies. Yeah. You know what I mean? And you I think when that is infringed upon, like the choice, it's just like, no, this is not going to work. I do have a question, though. This might be like an experiment. Could you guys think of an argument of why people would be pro-life? Like, why...
Religion. Yeah, because give this child a chance. You never know. Like, you don't, you're shaming the baby because of situations of your that choices. He didn't have to, he didn't deal with.
Like that fucking Nick Cannon song, Can I Live? You know, like, can I fucking live? Like,
but then it's weird because it's like, they're not even, they're, okay, they have a heartbeat. They say because it has a heartbeat, you can't have an abortion.
But it's still a little
But it's like, it's still, it don't have hands. It's not viable to live. Like, it just has, like, nothing.
Trump passed a law where you could have an abortion up until, like,
Yeah, I thought that was happening in New York. Somebody told me that.
I thought that was ridiculous.
That's crazy.
That one was insane. They said up until 9 months.
That should be illegal.
So what's that's a real baby.
What do y'all think the line is? Where's the line?
I think
6 weeks. No.
6 weeks is when you find out.
I think it should.
I think it's just up to the mother. I don't know. I feel like
I'm
going to
say 3 months. I'm going to say three months.
Baby shower, bro.
Yeah, if she has
a baby shower,
she has a baby shower, she can take the baby away.
The baby shower be at like 7 months.
She has to have the baby. You're going to have so many people who went to that baby shower like.
Man.
What the
baby shower gonna be like, no gifts, only like, money, Jesus. Only money. Like,
no, that part at that time it's actual
too
murder.
Too far.
At that point it's murder.
If
I go to a baby shower, if I go to a baby shower and then later on found out she aborted the baby, she's getting blocked.
Y'all
get
that shit back.
What if it's your cousin? She getting blocked.
We are no longer friends.
Yeah, she getting blocked.
So realistically, how long? What? How many months?
3 months.
You're saying up until the baby shower.
I'm saying up until it's like, you know,
it starts kicking.
Kicking and shit.
Okay, so when it develops a foot.
Yeah, when I start feeling life, like once you get that connection of, I mean, I guess not, but.
But you're like, you never know because.
Never mind.
Yeah, I mean, you could never be connected to it.
Gain a connection with the baby as soon as they become their pregnant.
No funny.
But that's not somebody who would want an abortion.
I had my abortion at, I believe, 8 weeks. I found out at 6 weeks. I had my abortion at 8 weeks. And once I seen that little picture.
They showed you it
when I found out I was pregnant.
Oh, the ultrasound. No, I'm talking about. No, I'm talking about the abortion.
It's like, wow, I wait 9 months.
That's what I'm saying. Tyler showed me that.
Did you ever think about?
Cool. I think about it's cool, but it's like still.
Did you ever think about keeping it?
Absolutely. I did think about keeping it. For me, my situation was kind of like some of the stuff y'all brought up. I was with my boyfriend. We were together for like a few months. I was on some dumb shit. Like I used to like, this is my first boyfriend, first like real unprotected sex. Y'all know it feels different, right?
Yeah.
And then I'll be there, and then he'd be like trying to get me up. I'm like, no! And I would just stay on, and he would just look at me like I'm crazy.
Oh, a trapper.
I was like trapping.
That's a trapper.
When he says get off, and you say no, you're trapping.
You're a trapper, leg wrapper.
If I say get out, and you say no, you're trapping.
Done to me before. Like that shit is.
That's
scary.
Assault.
It's
that's
scary.
Sexual assault. I'm not
that
even.
Scary.
That's
right.
That's it is. It is. It can be.
That's.
Granted,
like, I don't know. Like, is it rape? When you call it rape?
That's the point.
Okay, guys, we were not scared. Even talking about
me. I'm like, get off.
And they're like, no.
And
then afterwards, I was just like,
that's rape.
And then
that's
after, rape. I'm just like,
and then in the motion, it feels good. Like, no.
Yeah,
like, what?
Like, no. And it's like, you don't really want me to. And then afterwards, I would just be like, and I would like walk to the bathroom. You know, you gotta go pee.
No,
because the cum is inside of you.
They say
no, but you can't walk too much, or the cum is gonna start dripping. So you gotta walk like this to the bathroom.
Let it drip. Wipe it off.
And then you go sit in the toilet, and you squeeze all the cum down the toilet.
They say you
have
that was
my thing.
That
was my thing. I don't know what part of me
didn't think she was gonna get pregnant.
This is how you have a baby. I just thought, look, when
exactly,
a guy comes
like,
in front of you,
I didn't swallow
it. Happened while I was walking and it was dripping. Yeah, that's when I got pregnant.
I didn't walk fast enough. I think for me, I just love the feeling of like a man coming inside of you. It's so powerful.
But you know,
Tyler said.
Understandable.
Yeah, understandable.
I was 19 years old, very super naive, and RB still has not looked up, y'all. From my, it's okay.
It's so, like, what did you just make me do?
He was so upset. And my ex, he was a few years older than me, too. So he would just, like, think I was crazy. And I'd be like, yeah.
And he was like, what?
Fun and flirty. No, not even 20.
That's insane. I'm triggered too, honestly.
Yeah, so it was like, it was freaking. I was like, home for Christmas break. I went to go, I don't know, something was weird. My period was late. I took a test. The shit said pregnant. I was sitting there like, what?
I remember that shit.
What? It was so crazy. I called him. And I told him, and he came over, and we were just, like, you know, like, just cuddling and just, like, just so, felt so weird, you know what I mean? But then after we actually talked about it, he was more so, like, yeah, I think you should have an abortion. I was more so, you know, let's juggle both ideas. Let's weigh the pros and cons. He was just, like, no.
Did the nigga say it?
Obviously, you would want it.
It's done.
Once he said it, she was a leg wrapper checker.
We're good.
I'm aborted.
We're good.
I think for me,
oh my God, I would be like, once he said that, I would just be like,
it would hurt him saying
it. Yeah, the baby would fall right out.
Yeah,
him saying it would hurt so much.
My God. I think that's how it was. That's how it was for me. It really hurt me, and it made me feel like, oh my gosh, like, you don't want to
fuck with me.
Like, we can figure this out. Like, you know what I mean?
He's like, I'm not figuring this out with you.
See, the thing is, look. Yeah, the thing is, he never wanted that.
I want no part.
He never wanted that. You was the one keeping your legs wrapped around.
Me?
Now at this point, he's like, no.
Yeah, like, no, bitch. Like, this is not it.
Next time, I'm knocking you off.
Yeah. He was just trying to tell me, like, all these different reasons.
Yeah. No.
Fuck that.
Fuck semen.
Listen, don't throw me off your dick. I'm smacking the shit out of you.
He told me that the earth was too overpopulated, that we shouldn't have kids.
That was his reason?
What?
Bullshit. Now he's just talking. He's just talking. He can't say we're not ready. The world's overpopulated? No.
It's too dangerous.
He was like, this bitch need to have the abortion by any means. I'm writing a fucking essay, bitch.
The world is overpopulated. Bitch.
I'm debating you, bitch. No, the world's overpopulated.
If you have a child, the earth is dropping.
He was like, if you have the baby, I'm going to take the baby. Like, he just started scaring me. I was like, what, nigga? Like, oh, no.
Oh, he did say, he said his family was going to take the baby and raise it.
He was like, his family, like, no, nobody can know that he had a baby. Like, he was just, like, scaring me.
I'm like, okay, yeah. Okay,
and I was in that position.
Okay.
He had a secret marriage.
He was like, I was in a position where I was like, I don't want to raise a child with the, first of all, the way the parent, the father doesn't want the kid. That sounds like so traumatic for a child.
The mom not wanting it is bad, but seeing the father don't want it, it's like, okay. It hurts.
No. It hurts, but it's just, that's not something that I wanted to.
Either way,
yeah, they both hurt.
Anybody not wanting a child, it hurts.
It's just a bad situation. And I just like, I don't, that's not what I saw for myself. So I finally was just like, you know what? And then he's talking about he's gonna kidnap the baby. And I was like, who wants
that's this point? Leave me alone.
That's a lot of stress. He said, if you do, he started getting crazy. If you have it, I'm gonna take the baby and I'm gonna take it to Canada.
I'm gonna take the baby.
I was like,
where were y'all? Were y'all freshmen in high school or
no,
freshmen?
No, college. I was a freshman in college. Okay. He was like, a super senior.
I'm like, okay, you're crazy. Thank you for letting me know.
Dumbass.
I think he was trying to scare you.
Look at his face.
Have an abortion and don't try this shit again. A warning, a big warning.
I mean,
like, leave it alone.
For 6 years and still ain't get his bachelor's.
Nah, that happened.
Don't knock people. Don't knock.
That's life.
Don't knock people. I'm on my fifth year. I'm going on five.
Hey. On campus.
Hey.
Nah, okay. But no, but I think for me, even afterwards, which is another conversation that we don't have, after the whole abortion, like, I felt like I was dealing with a lot of this stuff by myself. It's really hard to try to communicate with a man about it because, like, you didn't go through it. You didn't have it inside of you. You didn't get it taken out of you.
You didn't open your legs and remove a baby.
They don't know that feeling. They don't know, like, it's serious, but they don't know how.
They don't know.
It's like a whole surgery, my nigga.
Literally surgery.
I just feel like they just don't. They will never get it. But we can't be mad because they will never understand it because they will never carry a baby. So it's like,
they will never carry a baby. They will never bleed from their dicks once a month. They will never have a baby from their dicks. They will never.
Have milk coming out their nipples.
Yo,
nothing.
So no matter, I feel like they can't say anything to have the real be more because they didn't even get periods. Yeah. So they don't even know. Like, they don't even know, like,
cramp. You know what a cramp is, boo?
Scientifically.
Hey, RB, you know what a cramp is?
Scientifically, what? Men get their periods every day.
What?
Get the fuck out of here.
What the fuck is that, RB?
I don't want... RB,
it's not, it's
we're,
not...
We don't even want to hear that.
Stop with that shit.
Here we go. Now niggas want to try to compare their shit to women.
Nah.
Now I'm mad.
I would never try to do that. But, like, as far as, like, organs go, like, there is a cycle within men that we get... something equivalent to a woman's menstrual cycle every single day.
Does it have cramps?
No, we don't have any symptoms.
Does it have cramps?
Back pain? Okay. You have blood coming out your dick?
That's
congratulations, RB.
But they said when you
congratulations, you have a period.
Baby, it's like the period pain times 1,000.
Yo,
so it's like,
I'm scared.
But to go further.
Don't keep up with y'all anger issues.
We know the seriousness.
You're going to be like, oh, I'm sorry, I'm on my period.
I don't keep y'all bitching for a day.
Never.
Every day.
We know the seriousness and severity of the issue. It's just that
what did you say?
Of course, Dee.
He's crying.
Thank you, Dee.
All I had was bitches.
Thank you, Dee. All right, so, see, you're fucking my shit up.
Do you guys understand the seriousness of the situation?
We understand the seriousness and the severity of the situation, but it's not in the perspective of a woman. It's in the perspective of a man bringing an entire child into this world that we are not ready for. Fuck, like, we don't go through, you know what I mean, fucking milk from our titties and shit and having a whole fucking round ass belly that's stemming from our penis. Like, that's not a thing we have to worry about. However,
that is
we
true.
Have to worry about, we have to worry about fucking providing finances, time. We're not going to be able to do regular shit.
To have fun. Be with your bros.
Not only y'all, but it's you thinking for yourself.
They want to be with their mans.
And fucking dick slap each other.
And have their periods.
Okay,
together.
It's basically going through the seriousness of, like, your whole world is about to change once a baby comes into this world.
Yeah.
And if you're not ready for that shit, if you're not, as a person, ready for that shit, then that has a different type of effect on a dude.
Mm-hmm,
and shit. Niggas do not know how to really readily identify or handle a lot of that shit.
Yeah, that's why they leave.
More than half the time. That's why niggas dip. That's why niggas be like,
they tell you to get an abortion.
Get that abortion.
The world is overpopulated and shit. I've never heard that shit.
That was pretty much that, and that he was gonna,
and he was
kidnap
gonna take
the baby.
It. He was gonna
either
take
that,
and for the
and
simple
I said, what about adoption?
He
said, no, he'll
carry.
Kidnap the baby over adoption.
You don't have to carry it. So it's like, if you want it or not, you're gonna still be doing the same thing.
And for, yeah, for the simple fact that we don't have to carry it. So if a nigga really feel definitely. Like I don't want this baby, he's.
But then what about the niggas that do want it, but the girl don't want it?
That's what I was gonna say.
Yeah, that's. I like, feel like we say that before.
Yeah, it's
that's
a dub.
The fuck?
Yeah, we did
but
talk
okay,
about
what
the
about
fuck.
Those niggas?
I feel like both parents need to want it.
What if those niggas you want?
Or
them, like,
I will
oh,
have it
what
and
if
I'll
I get
it.
Pregnant? What would you do? Oh, I'll be so happy. And you in your head like, damn.
Like, fuck.
I don't want this shit. What am I going
to do? So I can't. No, but then that leads back to my answer. Then you cannot tell him.
Because then nigga,
then you
start,
can't tell him, and then you're
because like you said,
so but you're not
horrible.
Gonna find out if he wants it or not.
Yeah,
we can ask him a question.
Yeah,
you can ask him, yo, what happened if you get pregnant, babe? What you gonna do? Yeah. Oh, I'm gonna be so happy. Oh, okay, never mind then. I'm gonna give you the news. Leave it alone.
Or just you know, birth control. But you know, I would never try to inflict birth control on a woman either because y'all, you know, different
you
birth control them. Have different.
Yeah,
people
say,
have
would,
different views.
For
on
me
it.
Personally, I would. I don't think I would ever take a birth control. I can't. I'm just so nervous. I like my periods are fine. It comes at once
but
a month.
But I even told you about my.
I feel good about experience. It. I don't care about my cramps.
I took birth control. I like taking birth control.
I didn't like.
I
mean, I'm.
Good. I don't mind it.
I didn't mind.
And I
took
know
birth
how
control.
Sensitive my body is too. So like, the wrong shit could fuck up my shit.
I took birth control my freshman year of college.
Splatty splat splat.
And it wasn't bad. It was very bad.
What happened? What happened to you?
I bled for like a long time, and then I went back to the fucking gynecologist. She said, oh, you gotta get adjusted. I said, bitch, no. Adjusted to
yeah,
what?
It affects people differently.
That don't make fucking sense.
I have
That doesn't make sense. Your period is unnatural to begin with.
It's a natural. Exactly. It hurts that much. Your period shouldn't be hurting.
Depending on which one you get, the one that the shot, you bleed for like about a month.
I'm not getting none of that shit.
A month to 3 months.
Yeah, I'm not getting that.
You bleed straight. And then you stop.
I don't got time. Like women that are, you see,
like that, I don't that should be a choice too.
I know when my period's coming.
Whether you want to be on birth control or not.
I don't know if I'm ovulating, but I know.
I know I'm taking
coming.
That first Monday
off. I know
off.
When it's coming up. I know what's going on. I know. Okay, I can't fuck you around this week. I know I'm about to have it next week. I know. I'm just so on myself. Like I know myself. Like I'm gonna be like, okay, I took the birth control. I don't know. I probably won't bleed for 4 months, but who knows? I'll probably bleed for the next 4 months after that. I don't have time
Ooh,
to think about
knows?
That.
I might be pregnant, but who knows?
I don't have time to think about everybody. That. I know that once that week, once that first of the week comes and my period's not there, uh-oh, let's get this shit checked out. I know it. Like, yes. I like to know myself. I don't want to be like, okay.
I feel you.
You know that. I just like, it's like you know your natural cycle.
Same. I like not having a period. That's why I took it. I took it
I'd be like,
not period part, and
it's only
I mean,
a week.
I've been on it for a while, but when I took it, I know it's like you bleed for 1 to 3 months, and then after that, you don't have your period for like as long as you stick to having it or whatever.
I need to know if I'm healthy.
And for me, I'm on top of my body, so I don't know. I know when something's wrong, when something is off. Mm-hmm. With my vagina, my body, I'm very on top of it. Bitch, I just walk around sniffing my shit, making sure everything good. Like, that's just me.
Sniff check, we good.
Just because, you know, because you never know, like, you get sniff check. And shit like that, whatever. Mm-hmm. I'm just like that, entwined my body. So when I took it, I was like, now I don't take it because I'm just like, you know, as you said, periods are like something that is good for your body. It regulates, it cleans out your body. It's a good thing to have. Because then once you get off of it, then you bleed again for like another 2-3 months.
All right, I have one more question. We're kind of running out of time, but I feel like this might be 3 months. This might be interesting. What if they made birth control illegal as well?
Birth control illegal?
Didn't they do something like that already?
What?
If they made birth control
because
illegal?
Because a lot of people you know, a lot of religious people don't use contraceptive because they're like, you know.
That's why they be having 80 million fucking kids.
What do y'all think about that?
Isn't that why they try to close out Planned Parenthood?
Yeah.
Right?
But I don't care. But
listen, condoms have been very good to me.
Yeah, condoms don't bother me. Fine. So it has.
That includes condoms too.
Yeah.
Oh. Birth control?
Birth control.
You think people would be more That's cautious crazy. About whether they're having sex with, or you think it would just go?
Yeah, I think people would be more cautious.
No, I'd be like, I only want the head.
I think it would be crazy.
I only want the head.
It would be crazy.
Call me. Call me in 5 minutes, okay?
I mean, like, we have all this.
You know they made birth control illegal, so you better.
Y'all are still having unprotected sex.
I'm like, Becky, call me in 5 minutes. I'm gonna get some head. Call me emergency. I'm out. That's it.
Catch the neck and dip.
Been looking for a reason to fuck raw.
And dip.
Exactly.
Do they need a reason?
They would just go fucking crazy.
Half the time they don't, but niggas been looking for
our niggas fucking raw with all of the rights.
That we would have condoms in our drawer, then they would be like, that's illegal.
They've been looking for the society.
I'm like, look, baby.
I mean, like, look, baby. If you go downstairs, look on the top count, the top shelf in the cabinet. Yeah, there's a saran wrap. You're going to wrap that shit up.
Get some lip bag. Put it on.
Gonna wrap that shit up.
That's gross.
That's it.
I got a story for that. That was funny.
You're disgusting.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Listen, when you ain't got something available and you young and
that's not even lubricated, bro.
I can't.
That is gross. But
hopefully she's lubricated and then that cancels it out.
That's disgusting. What about them fucking ridges and shit?
Exactly.
I can't.
All of them ridges when it's wrapped around.
He's whispering over here to me that it works.
The ridges help for the sensation. Don't some of the condoms have ridges?
Yeah, but those were specifically made for vagina.
Okay, y'all ever use the fire ice? But did it inside out?
That burns.
Yeah, that
ew. Why
it sounds like it's gonna trick you into having gonorrhea.
The fire ice.
Somebody told me
the fire ice is fire.
That's you burning
inside
out.
That's ridiculous. What is that even?
Inside out. Niggas don't know what they're doing.
Inside out. What do you mean inside out? Like not putting.
So question.
All right.
Question.
I don't know who.
Can I ask my question?
Yes.
That's what I'm saying.
What's
so
that?
For abortion wise, so what we're pretty much saying is that when you have a nigga, always talk about if you had a baby, how would you feel?
That's one of the conversations.
Sorry,
not even on my
list. Y'all should be on that type
that's
of time.
Crazy though, that like you can have sex with someone
and not be
and
able
not
to communicate.
To have conversations about
exactly.
Hey,
exactly. Fucking nuts.
Yeah,
that is absolutely.
If you can ask him, do you want to fuck? You can ask, would you have a baby with me?
Wow. So
how about
those conversations need to be had?
How about can I talk to you? How about can I talk to you about my feelings?
Like, hey, you want to fuck? Hey, you want to be unprotected?
First time you fucking this nigga, y'all hot and heavy. How did you feel if we maybe had a baby right now.
No, as soon as they say, oh, why do we gotta use a condom? Be like, but do you wanna have a baby? Ask them that. As soon as they say, why you have to have a condom? Do you wanna have a baby? One, two.
But that's how you know you shouldn't be having sex with that nigga, because that nigga gonna tell you the world is overpopulated.
Exactly. And when you hear that, you go home.
If a nigga can't be like,
my Uber is downstairs. I'm going home.
It's more about the people, though. I think it's more about the people.
But you're having sex and I met you last week. So let's talk, nigga.
Yeah, let's fucking talk.
Right. You can be in this pussy, you can be in this bread. If you want to have the naked talk, then what? Get left. Get right or get left. Period.
Uber's downstairs.
Period.
I would not have a problem doing that. What?
But I think, that's good. That you wouldn't have a problem with.
But that's the maturity of men.
That means that somebody else will come along and
get right.
Exactly.
But it's really
take care of your baby.
But it's a yes or no question. But then
take care of your baby, RB.
Or no.
But then it's going to be niggas who be like, yeah, just saying that because they want the pussy at that moment.
No. You can feel it.
And then when I come and stop on your face, don't be mad.
I know a couple niggas like that. Like that.
And I don't know no niggas like that.
I know a couple niggas like that. They my friends though. I ain't fucking them.
Wait, you don't know niggas like what?
Like RB?
Like that's about to lie to just get some pussy. Especially over that. Like, oh, you're okay with me having a baby? You're saying yes.
I'm talking about like.
But depending on how much you know the nigga.
Circumstantial. You would know if it's crazy or not. Like, it's like a weekend. And we fuck it for the first time. Like. There are niggas out here who just gonna be like,
you know what? Fuck, we ready here. Yes, I have a fucking
that
baby.
Conversation, and we gonna get it in because I'm not. Shit, and then it's gonna be a slowdown.
You see, you gotta do
texting.
Before you even get high. Before it gets hot
and
heavy.
It'll be a slowdown on texting, and I know you was not my king. So,
but we can't period. Take it as a hard question. We have to take it as a yes or no. If you got pregnant, would you have my baby? Oh,
exactly.
No?
It shouldn't be. Yeah. It shouldn't be an uncomfortable thing because y'all wanna, you wanna nut in me. You wanna have raw sex. You should be comfortable having a fucking baby.
But I feel like even
here's another layer of this. We're having raw sex, so forget anything because if I'm fucking somebody after a week, it's condom straight on.
That's you.
There's different.
That's you. Yeah, I was gonna say that's you.
Straight on, and the condom breaks. Now, boom.
Or that's damn. Or wait, or damn. Wait, tell me out, y'all. Or damn, that one time, the third fucking round when you ran out of condoms and you just want to fuck.
Third round.
Third round.
Yes.
Third round. And you just slide it in. That's fucking, that's
raw. Y'all got somebody in the first.
It don't be high and heavy then.
Nope. I put that on every dead relative I have. On all of them.
Relative.
Never.
Okay, but RB, now have you had raw, unprotected sex with someone that you didn't want to have a baby with?
Nope.
You said first week.
You're
fucking lying, RB.
Why am I lying?
Okay.
Please, no, I haven't.
Okay, yeah, make it that.
Punch you across the fucking room, bitch.
Well, I'm sorry, RB.
He almost punched you in the fucking face with his eyeballs.
Punchline punch. You about to get punchline punch.
With his eyeballs.
You know why? Because I take something like that very seriously.
Yeah.
Okay, that's you.
Even with people I've been in relationship with, or not really in relationships with, super like situationships with, and we have been without contraceptives or condoms. Every time, and granted, pre-cum is a thing too. I'm glad that it hasn't happened to me. But every time, when they say like right before you die, like your life flashed before your eyes. It's like if I'm having raw sex right before I come, the whole life of me having a child right now, just like
a whole thing. Junior,
you're not gonna be able to smoke. Bitch, you're gonna have to get another job. You need another one. Like you start thinking like, oh shit.
And that, and then those 0.2 seconds, I'm out of there.
And then you just blow right on her face.
So yeah, pretty much
facial.
Get that facial money.
Depend on that note.
Get that facial
and on
money.
That motherfucking note. We're gonna wrap the motherfucking show. Thank you guys so much for listening. Please, ladies, this was an amazing conversation.
Yes, yes.
I loved having all y'all different perspectives. Before
we love
we wrap
y'all.
It, I love you so much. Before we
love
wrap it, please let everyone know where they can find you and what you are working on right now.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Hey, hey, y'all. It's your girl, Staci B.
Hey, hey, hey Stace.
So, y'all, yeah, I'm just coming up with some new content in regards to, you know, my music and modeling. And, yeah, and I have a little show coming to you guys real soon. Sirens NYC Power, baby.
Let's get
okay.
it.
Wait.
Not funny, guys.
But yeah, like y'all. It. So stay tuned. Follow me at The Real Staci B. All right, on everything.
How do you spell it?
At The Real Staci B. At TheRealStaciB, baby.
It's Deandra. Wow.
That was cute.
So, guys.
No, wait, we're still doing the outro.
So, hi, guys. I'm Deandra, aka D Bomb. You can find me on YouTube at Deandra D, DiandraDee. Got some vlogs, some makeup videos, all that. And right now I'm just working on quitting my job, you know.
Okay.
Yes, I want to go back to school and find another job, communications and sociology. And I'm just going to be living my life, my best life this summer. So if you guys want to keep up with that, you can follow me on Instagram at D-Bomb, and that's D-E-E-B-O-M.
B-B, bitch!
Yeah, hey. 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 With my hood friends! Hey. 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 With my hood friends!
Hey.
Hey.
You can find, well, it's Tyler here. You can find me at @loveme_Ty, @loveme_Ty. And right now I'm just working on my writing, getting my writing skills back up. So you'll see some poetry on my page, hopefully soon, if I stop being a shy little bum. But you will see some poetry. I'm gonna start writing like screenplays and all these things. So you're gonna see my creative side, my creative secret side. So I'm gonna be going MIA a lot, but when I pop out, it's gonna be great things. So just stay tuned.
Yes. And also the modeling.
Yeah. And the modeling, yeah, I'm going crazy. Yeah, it's amazing. Just like my pictures, follow me on Instagram. Modeling. You can see my portfolio. I got secret stuff. Just let me know if you want some more pictures. And book me nice. All summer. What's up?
Yes. Hey. Bitch, you signed. We pay.
Yes. Yeah, period. Our signed model of the group. Okay.
Wagwan.
Period. And you guys are so awesome. Like, we fucking love you guys.
Yes, love you guys.
Love you guys too.
This is a perfect
conversation. Birds of a feather flock
perfect.
Together.
Perfect. Yeah, yes. I wouldn't have wanted to have anyone else for this conversation.
Okay, we're going to save our last shot. But thank you guys so much for watching on YouTube. Thank you guys so much on Instagram Live. We appreciate you guys so much. We just are going to continue to keep growing with our beautiful team and keep bringing you guys amazing content. So we appreciate all the love. You guys can follow your fave coho on Instagram at @everybodylovesbecky because everyone loves that Becky. You guys can also follow us on Instagram at The Whole Phase Memes. And don't forget to follow us on Twitter at The Whole Phase because we be tweeting that fire. Yes.
And don't forget to follow Sirens NYC. That's on Instagram, sirens.nyc. That's where we got all the poppin' babes on there. Okay.
Yes. If you guys are looking for creative inspiration, we try to keep that page more creative and for all of our vibey women of color. So check out that page.
And we got some big things coming motherfucking
big
soon.
Big things popping.
Little things stopping.
Big things popping.
Little things stupid.
What's up?
I said little things stupid.
Okay, come on. Don't do that. Yes, don't forget to follow us on YouTube, youtube.com/sirensnyc. You guys can catch the full episodes of all of our podcasts on there, as well as some other amazing content that's coming. I'm telling you. You gotta stay tuned. Tap in now before the prices go the fuck up, okay?
Tap, period.
Cause the price is going up.
Prices going up. These must be songs I don't know, but these are my song bitches over here, so I know.
They're tapped in.
Yeah. Also, don't forget to hit the notification bell when you subscribe to us on YouTube, so you can get a bling every time we ding.
Ding zing.
You did yourself? Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Okay. I just want to say I love all y'all. And I just want to say also, I didn't get to say this. when we're having these conversations, we need to also remember that other people are also included. Like, it's not just about women's bodies. Think about trans men, you know, they also have the same parts as well. So they need to be included in the conversation too. Oh, just wanted to add that into it. Exactly. Wow. They don't have access to abortions either because everybody was talking. But it's okay.
Like, damn, I'm a man. Sorry.
You know, yeah, like, yeah. Sorry. But yeah, y'all can follow me on Instagram at MJSmokesMJ. I'm going to be coming, you know, popping back on a gram, you know, with some graham crackers and a few.
Yes. Copyright. Where'd you get that from? Copyright. Who?
Graham crackers.
Yes. Cite that. Cite that.
I'm not saying.
Cite that. Graham crackers. Cite that, MJ.
No, Staci, tell us about the graham crackers.
Yeah, tell us about the graham crackers.
The word of today's episode is going to be graham crackers. Okay? Graham.
Can you spell it for us, Staci?
Oh, that it could be its perspective, but graham crackers. GRAMCRACKERS. Okay? And the definition of a graham cracker is a picture or video that cracks the motherfucking graham. Oh, I had two this weekend.
Period.
I had two this weekend.
How many did you have?
So next time you post a graham cracker, at me.
What should put it, baby? No, you guys have been
hashtag graham cracker.
Hashtag graham cracker. For real. For real.
Staci came up with that word, okay? Period.
Graham crackers. I like that.
So, MJ, some graham crackers is coming soon?
Yes, definitely.
Oh, shit.
Where can they find you, baby girl?
Oh, shit.
Where can they find you?
I already said, oh, MJ Smokes MJ. That's my main page. Then we got the tattoo page, MJ Smokes and Pokes. Hit me up. MJ Braids and Slays, come get your hair braided because it's looking crazy.
I love that.
Yeah, we see the different colors.
That's it?
Oh, yeah, that's it.
Cool.
And you already know it's your boy, your favorite liquor sponsor, coming through with that Punchline Punch. Today we were sipping that Henny Rita.
And I'm dead
with a little bit more Henny than the Rita.
Okay.
We
love you, Harvey. So just Henny.
Dediana.
Yeah, just Henny Henny with a little bit of Rita involved. You know what I mean? But if you want to try the Henny Rita and some more of my other drinks like Pink Walls, I got Dark Walls sitting in the freezer right now. Some
dark walls.
Yeah.
I don't know about the marketing.
You're gonna give us some.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Matter of fact, Steph, go get that out the freezer real quick.
Go get that out the freezer.
You got some dark walls.
You want to try this? The dark walls, the pink walls, or whatever walls that I got on my page. You know what I mean? Follow me at Punchline Punch everywhere. That's Instagram. That's Facebook. That's Twitter. You know what I mean? Here it come right there.
Yeah.
Ready? That do look a little darker than normal.
I thought we were shutting
this. Tyler, we just got to finish.
You know.
Also,
chance to pink walls.
Just cheers to pink
walls. That's how I like it.
Dark walls.
This is just how I like it. Ooh, it's cold and refreshing.
The darker the berry, the sweeter the juice, baby.
The darker the walls.
The darker the walls, the sweeter the punch.
Tyler, you got stuck?
I got stuck.
Thank you.
Is that still looking at
you? Oh, you want to put it down?
Is this like dark liquor, though?
Yes.
That's what the dark walls is.
Just making sure.
Y'all, thank you. Did you finish?
Nah, I ain't finished. But follow me at Punchline Punch on Instagram, Punchline Punch on Twitter, Punchline Punch on Facebook. I got a whole summer list coming out right now. It's about to be lit. So, you know what I mean? Holla at your boy.
Yes. And we fucking love you guys. Thank you guys so much for always listening, for following us, for all that good shit. We fuck with y'all OD. We got a few more episodes of the season left. So let me tell you, we're going to come correct with it, okay? We're going to make sure we finish this shit with a bang.
But go hard or go home.
Okay? We got all these. Come on, come into camp.
Come here. Come in the main shot.
Just go to YouTube.
In the main shot.
What the fuck? Hey.
Wait, are we
going to go hard or go home?
We got the baddest crew in NYC.
I told y'all, all my bitches is bad, okay? Period.
Yes, you need to come in. I don't know if they ever seen you, because this is Led Eye Photographer slash new member of Sirens B.
Hey.
So, let me tell y'all, just stay tuned because we do all of this for you. Well, for us, but for you.
Yo,
okay?
Steph, come here. Show the shorties that you're making bun, man.
Yeah, show them the bun. Show them the bun.
This is...
Hey! Come on, nice and tick.
His edge is better than half y'all bitches out there. So, period. Get it right.
Steph is going to be coming on as Punchline Punch's cameraman.
Oh, shit. Oh. So, the team is
y'all,
growing.
Y'all okay. Y'all going to be seeing a lot more of him.
Okay, you know that's lit.
Period.
All I know is, I love this. This is exactly what I've been doing.
All right, we'll see you guys.
This is exactly
we'll
how
see you guys
like
next week, bitch. Bye.
Bye. Bye.